Well, good Monday morning, everyone. Thanks for tuning in to Inspiration for Today. Let's get the week started off right. What's a week from today? That's right, July 4th, the birthday that America celebrates. What an awesome day. And I don't know about you, but I've just been feeling the need to have a patriotic week. And by patriotic, I just mean celebrating America, the good things about America. I'm so tired of the media and the television telling me how bad everything is and we're this and that, and it's never a pleasant word said about us. I don't know about you, I'm tired of it. I want to celebrate America for what it is, a land where God's grace has been evident from day one. It was a country founded by Christians, not just so it would be a Christian country, but so all religions could have the freedom of worship. But to hide the fact that it was Christians who started it is just, that in itself is a lie. So we're going to celebrate with some of the best shows that we've done over these, you know, we've done well over 1,000 shows on Inspiration for Today. And I've picked out some of my favorite shows because I just want to re-show them, because they just, not only America, but the men and women who fought and died for it and that were willing to give of their life for this country. And rightly so. It's the land of the free, a land of opportunity. I love this country. This scene behind me this was my favorite boat in the Newport Boat Parade a few years ago. And so that's just, many, many boats were out that day. All were decked out with the red, white, and blue. So we're going to enjoy that ourselves. Hey, I wanted before those shows, the historical shows that we've done over the years start tomorrow. I wanted to spend today just talking about why it's okay, if not downright good, to celebrate our own country. You know, Philippians 3:20 says our citizenship is in heaven. That's verse we've dug it. You know, we were talking about heaven all last week. So I'm thrilled that that's where you and I, you're a follower of Jesus, that's where you and I are going to spend our eternities. And so I am excited about that. But right now we're here. And sometimes it's really easy for me to listen to what I'm lately been told over and over again, that our country is this and that, and start to have a bad feeling about it. And it's not true. By the way, did you see the movie Top Gun, Maverick? I saw it with my grandson, and I'm sad there's some swearing in it, but it's men and women fighting for America. I felt it's finally a movie that seems patriotic to me. I was excited about that. But here's going to be our verse for today. It comes from Romans, therefore written by Paul, chapter 13, at verse 1. It says, well, I'll read the whole verse, and the part of it will be our verse for the day. Everyone must submit himself to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. The authorities that exist have been established by God. And it's those last phrases that I need to remind myself. Sometimes I get upset over elections. And yes, as citizens, we're to do our, to vote. That's how this country is governed. And so we actually do have a say in who those authorities are. But it does say the authorities that exist have been established by God. Wow. That's something that is difficult at times. That in his sovereignty and in his wisdom, he has allowed things that they just don't seem right. But he sees the bigger picture. And, you know, we've noted over the years that when we read about end times and Jesus coming back and then the tribulation and so forth, the United States is never mentioned. And I don't know if that means, I don't know what it means, to be frank with you. I know some people act like they totally understand everything, but I don't. And in that case, does that mean America's in decline and not a big player at the end times? Maybe it does. I don't know. But I do know that we are here, we're to submit to the laws of the land, and when they don't break God's law, and then just rejoice. And when we see the good things about America, be sure you give praise to where they come from. It's from the Lord God himself. All good things come from God. And so I hope it'll lift your heart this week to have a patriotic week. You know, when Jesus was asked, should you conform to the current government? And he was asked that in a fly way. In Matthew chapter 22, the Pharisees come to him and they say, "Teacher, we knew you're a man of integrity and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, and you aren't swayed by men. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" And of course, Caesar was doing numerous bad things also. And so what would Jesus say? Chapter 22, verse 18, "But Jesus, knowing their evil intent, said, 'You hypocrites, why are you trying to trap me? Show me the coin that is used for paying tax.' And they brought him a denarius, and he asked him, 'Whose portrait is this? And whose inscription?' And they said, 'Caesar's.' Then he said to them, 'Give to Caesar what is Caesar's, and give to God what is God.'" So what's he saying? Saying, pay your taxes. Be a citizen. This is the country where God has sovereignly placed you, and it was in Israel at a time under Roman rule, and yet they were to pay their taxes. Amen. I think that the lesson is clear for us, that we're to be a model citizen of our country, including voting, including paying taxes, including following the laws. And then look at the good, I just encourage you, let's look at the good things of this country together. It's a great country. It's the land of the free. And so I know you and I feel the same way. So that's what we're going to do this week, leading up to July 4th celebration. I hope you have some good plans to celebrate the birthday of this country. There are events right here in Laguna Woods we can all do. And we want to just rejoice, praise God. We're on Sunday in Clubhouse 5. We are really going to do that in our worship service. Praise God for having put us in such a great country. God bless. Have a great week. We'll see you tomorrow as we start some great shows. See you then.